Hello everyone and welcome to the new hits where I cover brand new top 40 entries, judging their quality and how much longevity I think they'll have. This week I decided to combine two to give myself a break after the big video last week, which ended up working out perfectly as this would have been a two song video otherwise. With the 6th and 13th we've got some hip hop and country to check out, plus a remix. Let's get started. Bitch, I got my own, if I don't need security. Pooh Shiesty gets his first big charting song here with an assist from Lil Durk, rap's biggest rising star at the moment, who I'll be covering again later in the video, and the former's new mixtape should boost it even higher. The song focuses on the violence, the title line essentially being an over my dead body statement, and the song itself full of shooting references, and while Durk brings the intensity the song needs, Pooh finds himself somewhere closer to the sinister monotone of a 21 Savage in his verse, and while bringing a catchy hook, he fails to reach that artist's peaks. The production with its up and down piano melody is a bit weak, the piano sounding overly fake. However, for all its stumbles, most of them are just nitpicking. I wouldn't skip this song if it came on in a playlist, and it captures the energy it's going for well. Passable, but this lane has been trotting constantly before and in far superior manner, giving this a 5 out of 10, okay. I honestly have high hopes for the chart run for this one. It'll only crack the top 20 briefly off that mixtape, but I can see it as a solid presence below in the top 40 for a good little bit. Now for this. We just trying to catch a good time. Old Town Road-esque fusions of trap and country elements have been few and far between, as one might expect for a trend so intrinsically tied to one song. We had the dance challenge attempt at the Get Up and briefly the ridiculous My Truck from Breland last year, but otherwise this is the first similar song to show up in a while. Worth noting is that none of the aforementioned songs are particularly good, and this is no exception. There's nothing offensively bad about this track, but that's just because there is just nothing to this track. It's lyrically another having fun track with no embellishments. The production is rote even compared to a The Get Up, and as for Niko Moon himself, it has been a very long time since I've seen a performer with this little presence on his own song. There is absolutely nothing about this guy that hooks you in. He's just there. That's really the guiding phrase of the song. It's just there, and sometimes not doing a thing is worse than doing anything poorly. This gets a 2 out of 10. Bad. I could see this getting pop pickups, not to a massive degree, but enough for it to stick around and maybe break top 20. Next up, a big riser. And now we see another new hitmaker, with their debut from over a year ago making it big thanks to a remix I'll get to next. As the name suggests, in this song BRS Kash describes a girl he's engaging with sexually but not romantically, but some lines suggest he's catching feelings regardless. I've heard negatively of this song, so I wasn't expecting much going in, but I have to say, this blew away those low expectations. Aside from the throat babies in the hook in the end of that second verse, the lyrics are nothing cringeworthy by dirty rap standards, and a couple good bars show up too. In particular, one of my favorites of the year so far might be, "With a mouth like that, she can talk her way out of going to jail. With a mouth like that, if you go to jail, I'll pay your bail." The production features a cool Rod Wave-esque piano line, much more dynamic than Back in Bloods, and BRS Kash proves more than capable on the mic, though more so rapping than singing. This isn't anything special, and maybe I'm being kind, but I was expecting something terrible and heard this chill melodic trap cut with competence all around, so I'll give it the props I want to. This gets a 6 out of 10 decent. And now, another thing I certainly wasn't expecting going in, a considerable downgrade, to the point where I think BRS Kash is carrying his star-studded features on his back here. He does a brand new verse where he brings even more impressive flows to the mix, though with less lyrical game. DaBaby is competent, but I feel skeptical about how well he fits here, but he's certainly more worth coming here for than the City Girls, who actively work against the song. I wasn't expecting much from Young Miami, who I wasn't a fan of to begin with, and sure enough, she's her usual unimpressive and occasionally irritating self, but the worst part of the song being the second half of JT's verse, where she tries to go melodic and fails miserably, was very depressing. All in all, and I still can't believe I'm saying this, this song would have been so much better if it was just the no-name on it. 4 out of 10, mediocre. Chances of these songs, I'm not too certain. Last time this remix team-up happened, coincidentally enough the only other time I've covered an uncredited remix, the song managed to just sneak on the year-end in its last week. This track, though, is much farther in its run. I think it'll do better, but not by much. Now this week's two tracks, starting with... 2020 was a very promising year for the future of women in country, with Maren Morris and Gabby Barrett having their dominant turns. Hopefully 2021 can deliver on this promise. But for now, we have a new female country arrival, potentially the biggest ever hit for Ballerini, a more pop-leaning artist who's been a consistent presence for a few years now. This song takes on one of the more stereotypical country song concepts, drinking away your sorrows, in this case following a breakup. The aforementioned pop-tinged country sound is in full swing, and not really my thing, but what I do enjoy here are some of the lyrical details and Kelsea as a performer. There's some funny lyrics, and with the upbeat production and the slightly sarcastic tinge to Kelsea's tone, the song is clearly intending to be taken as tongue-in-cheek, a good change of pace from the serious nature of most of these types of songs. Not an excellent country song, but a change of pace from the usual, and for the most part a welcome one. I'll give it a 6 out of 10, decent. This looks like it has a good shot at big success, especially if Pop is willing to give a drinking song a chance. We'll have to see. And finally, bringing us full circle, we're back with Lil Durk and yet another piano-driven trap beat, this time with the Lil Baby accompaniment getting his deluxe its biggest track. I don't have all that much to say about this one, really. It's your standard come-up story done unimpressively. Durk and Baby both have energy, but neither go as hard as I would have hoped them to. If Durk brought what he did on Back in Blood to this, it would have been drastically improved. The beat is pretty damn good, but otherwise, like with that other song, I don't see much of a reason to return to this one compared to other songs of its ilk, or even other Lil Durk songs, feeling a 5 out of 10 okay here. This doesn't seem to be getting all that much promotion, so it's not going to stay around, at least for now. Could easily be a single later down the line. So, that's our week. Not my favorite, a couple unfun experiences, and nothing truly excellent. Let's hope for better in future. Next week, we have the big new track from Cardi B, and likely her WAP cohort Megan Thee Stallion bringing the latest single from her album into the top 40. Until next time, see you on the next episode of The New Hits.